Good afternoon, students. I hope you are doing well. Hope you have liked our video lectures. Please enroll today. During this time of corona, we are also uploading these videos for you. You can also enroll for these videos. Give us a call on 8805-137-642 today. So in yesterday's video, we had learned what is a skeletal chemical equation. So a reaction or a chemical equation which is not balanced is called as a skeletal chemical equation. As you can see, magnesium is balanced on both LHS and RHS, but oxygen is not balanced, and oxygen on LHS is 2, RHS is 1. So such type of equations are called skeletal chemical equations. Now, this is the example which I had given you for revision. This is the type of reaction which is balanced. But today we are going to learn how to balance an unbalanced chemical equation. Now, before I go to this topic, first thing you need to remember is the reaction which is given here, iron plus water gives ferrous oxide plus hydrogen. In the first place, can I change the reactants and can I change the product? The answer to this question is I cannot change the given reactants and the given products. So always in a chemical reaction, the reactants and the products remain the same. What do you need to change? You need to change the numbers. Next thing to remember before I go ahead, can I change this number? Can I change this number? Can I change 4? Can I change 2? No, I cannot change 2, I cannot change 3, I cannot change 4, I cannot change H2. Now, if you ask me a question, why? Let's consider an example. Concentrate here very carefully, pay your full attention. This is H2O. What is H2O? Water. Now, can I change this to balance the chemical reaction? I cannot change this two. You will ask me why. If I change this two, what will happen? Let's change it to 3. So water, the original formula of a compound water is H2O. I'll change to H3O. Is it water anymore? It is not. So what we have learnt in our 9th standard is water, which is a compound, always has a formula H2O. You go wherever you want. You go to USA, you go to UK, you come in India, you take refrigerated water, you take normal bottled water, the formula of the compound water will always be H2O. Now you will get the answer to my question, can I change this too? No, I cannot change this too, because compound is a substance which has a fixed formula, water, H2O. I can never change this H2O to H3O, H4O, I cannot change that. This is the first point to remember. Now, before balancing a chemical reaction, before making the LHS and RHS equal, I need to understand that I cannot change these formulas. Next, second point. Can I change the constituents of this reaction? No, I cannot change. If they have given you in your exam, iron plus water gives ferrous oxide plus hydrogen, first thing you need to do is convert iron into symbolic form, which is Fe. Water to its symbolic form, which is H2O. Ferrous oxide to its symbolic form, which is Fe3O4. Hydrogen to its symbolic form, which is H2. Where will you get this symbols and compound names from? You must be thorough with your 9th standard CBSE chapter 3 and 4. If you are thorough with those chapters, then these reactions balancing will be very simpler for you. So in your exam, they will give you this particular equation. You need to begin from here and go forward. So the first point is, I have converted this word equation to a symbolic representation, which is Fe plus H2O gives Fe3O4 plus H2. Now, before balancing a chemical reaction, I need to know whether the reaction is balanced or unbalanced. So let's have a look here. Fe, how many atoms of Fe on LHS? 1. Nothing means 1. How many atoms of Fe on RHS? Fe is 3. This 3 I have written here. So Fe on LHS is 1 and RHS is 3. So is it balanced? No, it is this way. Fe on LHS 1, Fe on RHS 3. Not balanced. I got the first hint that this chemical reaction is not balanced. Let's move on to the next element, hydrogen. Hydrogen on left hand side, 2. Hydrogen on right hand side, 2. Hydrogen is balanced. Next, let's move on to another element, which is oxygen. Oxygen on left hand side, 1. Right hand side, 4. This 4 I have written here. Now you will say hydrogen is balanced and Fe and oxygen are not balanced. So what to do now? You have to remember here that if any of the one atoms of the entire chemical reaction is not balanced, you will need to balance the chemical reaction. So this is the first step. I'll repeat again. Where did we start from? This will be the chemical equation, chemical reaction in word form, which will be given in your exam. Next, what do I need to do? I need to convert it from the word form to the symbolic form. Where will I get the symbols from? 9th standard CBSE chapter 3 and 4. Next, how do I, before balancing a chemical reaction, how do I understand it is unbalanced? Look at the atoms on left hand side and right hand side. Left hand side atoms are written here, right hand side atoms are written here. So you see Fe and oxygen are not balanced. This is an unbalanced chemical equation called a skeletal chemical equation. So this is the first step of balancing a chemical reaction, that you should understand the chemical reaction is not balanced. Okay, let's move on to the next part. Now, I will tell you step by step how to balance this reaction. So you need not remember these steps, what I have given here. Slowly and steadily, as you progress with your 10th CBSE, you will understand and automatically it will come to your mind how to balance a chemical reaction. But for now, since this is new, this is the beginning, you need to learn it step by step. So let's consider the first step. Step 1. Draw boxes around each reactant and product. So Fe is the first reactant. Green are reactants. Red are products. Blue is the arrow. Fe is the first reactant. I put a box around it. Plus, which is the second reactant? H2O. I put a box around it. Next, first product, Fe3O4. Put a box around it. H2, put a box around it. So step 1 is draw boxes around each reactant and product. I have drawn the boxes. Very simple to understand. Where did I begin? Word equation, symbolic representation. I understand the chemical equation is not balanced. What do? I balance. I start balancing the chemical reaction. In that balancing, what is the first step? Draw boxes around each element. Next, step number 2. List the number of atoms on LHS and RHS as shown. Now, be careful here. Fe, nothing means 1. On RHS, Fe, 3. You have to consider the number written here. Fe is 3. Next, hydrogen. Hydrogen is 2. Hydrogen is 2. Next, oxygen. Oxygen is 1. Nothing means 1. Oxygen is 4. Again, step number 2. I understand that the reaction is not balanced. Next, step number 3. Select compound with maximum atoms. Here, it is Fe3O4. Select the compound with the maximum atoms. Here, it is Fe3O4. Next, select element which has maximum atoms. O. Now, focus here. Fe3O4. How many atoms? 4 plus 3. So, this is the compound. This is the formula which has maximum number of atoms. Means 4 plus 3 equal to 7. Count any of the atoms in any of the reactant or product. We'll count Fe, 1 atom. We'll count H2O, 3 atoms. H2 and O, 1. 2 plus 1, 3. We will count Fe3O4, 3 plus 4, 7 and H2 2. So which is the atom, which is the compound which has maximum number of atoms? It is Fe3O4. So I begin balancing the chemical reaction with the compound which has maximum number of atoms. This is the step number 3. In that also, I have now understood that Fe3O4 has the maximum number of atoms in this chemical reaction, which is 7. Next, in that Fe3O4 also I have Fe and O. Now where to begin? Next step, select element which has maximum atoms. Now Fe is 3 and O is 4. So first I have to begin with O, because O is 4 and Fe is 3. I'll repeat it again. Step 1 is draw boxes. So around every element, every compound, you have drawn boxes. Next, list the number of atoms on LHS and RHS. I have listed it here. I understand that the chemical reaction is not balanced. Step number 3, I start balancing the chemical reaction. When I start, I have 4 options: Fe, H2O, Fe3O4, H2. Where do I begin? So my first consideration will be find the compound with maximum atoms. So I understand Fe3O4 has 7 atoms and I start balancing the chemical reaction with Fe3O4. In that also, I have a question whether to begin with Fe or O. Again count, Fe is 3, O is 4. So I begin with O, which has 4 atoms, maximum number of atoms. Next, atoms of oxygen, initial 1 in H2O, 1 in H2O. So there is 1 atom of oxygen in H2O. Next, 4 in Fe3O4. So 4 in Fe3O4. How do I balance? What do I do to balance? So balance means I need the same number of atoms on LHS and RHS. LHS, I have 1 atom, and RHS, I have 4 atoms. So I should add 4, 1 into 4. That is, to balance in reactants, I need 1 into 4, that is equal to 4. In products, I already have 4, and hence on left hand side, I have multiplied this 1 by 4. Means how to write that? So Fe remained just like that. We had already considered that O is 4, not balanced, and for that I balanced this particular H2O. So I write a 4 here. This 4 is written. Now let's consider oxygen. When I write the number beyond the box, means before the box, it is applicable for H2 and it is applicable for O. Remember this. This particular number 3 and 4 is applicable for Fe and O respectively. This 2 is applicable for hydrogen. But now this 4, which I have written in black bold outside the box, is applicable for H2. At the same time, it is applicable also for O. Okay. So step number 3 was find the maximum number of atoms, which is Fe3O4. In that, oxygen has maximum. Begin balancing the chemical reaction with oxygen. Here it is 4, so I wrote a 4 here. Fine, let's move to step number 4. Iron and hydrogen atoms are not balanced. Start with hydrogen next. Now look here very carefully. Hydrogen, how to count hydrogen now? 4 into 2, 4 into 2 is 8. So now, when you have balanced oxygen, hydrogen has become not balanced. So we need to balance hydrogen now. 4 into 2, 8 initial, 8 in 4H2O. 4 into 2, 8 in 4H2O. On the right hand side, 2 in H2. You have 2 on RHS and 4 on 8 on LHS. So again, when I balance oxygen, hydrogen becomes unbalanced. So where do I start? Do I balance iron first or do I balance hydrogen first? So you can begin with hydrogen. So initial 4 into 2, 8. In the product, hydrogen is 2. So now, what do I do? I already have 8, which is a bigger number on the left hand side. On the right hand side, I multiply this 2 by 4 in order to get 8 as a number. So Fe plus 4H2O. This is the same reaction. Fe plus 4H2O, right? Gives Fe3O4. Now, instead of H2, what will I write? 4H2. 4 2s are 8. 4 2s are 8. Now, is hydrogen balanced? Yes. Oxygen balanced. Hydrogen balanced. I will show you again. 4 2s are 8. 4 2s are 8. So, 8 on the left hand side, 8 on the right hand side. So, now hydrogen and oxygen both are balanced. Now, only one element remains, which is Fe. Pick the third element which is not balanced. So only Fe remains which is not balanced. Initial, 1 in Fe and 3 in Fe3O4. Now let's see. On the left hand side you have Fe as 1. On the right hand side you have Fe as 3. So is Fe balanced? No, it is unbalanced. Left hand side, right hand side you have 3. Left hand side you have 1. So in order to balance that, 1 into 3, and in products it is 3. So what will I do? I'll write 3Fe plus 4H2O gives Fe3O4 plus 4H2O, H2. Now, let's have a look here. Let's count Fe on LHS. 3Fe, RHS, 3Fe, Fe is balanced. Next, H2, 4H2, 4 into 2, 8. 4 into 2, 8. Hydrogen is balanced. Next, oxygen. When this 4 is written outside the box, it is applicable for entire formula. 4 oxygen. 4 oxygen. So all the elements are balanced. The entire chemical reaction is balanced. So there are only 5 steps. Firstly, you will find it hard to understand how to balance. But slowly and steadily, you will on your own find numbers in such a manner that the reaction gets balanced. There is no need to remember these steps, but you can learn these equations according to how I am learning them. 3Fe plus 4H2O gives Fe3O4 plus 4H2. This is how you can remember these equations. You have to repeatedly learn the numbers, because the same chemical reactions are repeated time and again in your question papers. So these are the steps to balance a chemical reaction. Next, writing the physical states. Now it is important to know the physical state of every compound. It can be solid, it can be liquid, gas and aqueous. So for solid, when the compound is solid or when the metal is solid, a small s is written in the bracket. When the compound is a gas, a small g is written as a subscript. When, again, the product is a solid, a small s is written as a subscript. And this was a gas and hence it is written as g. So, is it necessary to write these states? Yes, it is. So, sometimes they can ask you a question, write the states of the given following chemical reaction. So you need to remember the states, you need to remember how to balance a chemical reaction, and please understand, one number, a slightest mistake and your entire one mark will be gone, because if one atom is not balanced, there is no use balancing other atoms. Next, the second most important criteria is writing temperature, pressure and catalyst. So some reactions take place only at a certain specific temperature. These reactions must have temperature written on it or must have pressure written on it. So here, for this reaction to proceed, there is a certain amount of pressure required. What is that pressure? 340 atmosphere. So for this reaction, I have given pressure as a symbol. Next, third point is, can you balance this equation and write solid, gas or liquid? Now, how can I write solid, gas or liquid? It is simple. When you are held the magnesium ribbon in your tongs, magnesium was a solid. So can I write here S? Yes. The next, oxygen. Where did oxygen come from? Air. In air, oxygen is present in the form of a gas. So write here G. Very simple. Next, magnesium oxide. Magnesium oxide I had collected in a watch glass. So it was in the solid form. So I write here S. Simple. Correct? So this magnesium oxide, magnesium is solid. Oxygen is gas and magnesium oxide is solid. So I have written solid, gas, solid. So this is how a state for a chemical reaction is written. So now we will revise once again. So in the first step, do not get anxious because you are not understanding. Repeat the video continuously and you will get how to balance chemical equation. So first I have written, this will be the format they will give you in your exam. You need to write the symbolic form. Fe plus H2 gives Fe3O4 plus H2. First thing is you need to understand that the chemical reaction is unbalanced. How? Find the number of atoms on LHS, find the number of atoms on RHS. Not balanced. Proceed further for step number 1. Step number 1 was to draw boxes. Draw a box for this particular compound, this particular compound, this and last one. This is step number 1. Second, step number 2. List the number of atoms on LHS and RHS as shown. So Fe is 1, Fe is 3. Hydrogen, hydrogen is 2, hydrogen is 2. Oxygen, oxygen is 1, oxygen is 4. So I understand the reaction is unbalanced. Move to step 3. Select compound with maximum atoms. This compound, this element, metal iron, has only one atom. 1, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 4, 7 and 2. So which compound has the maximum number of atoms? Fe3O4. So now the next question is, do I begin with Fe or do I begin with O? I begin with O because O is 4 and Fe is 3. How to balance? Initial, 1 in H2O. So oxygen is 1 on the left hand side, oxygen is 4 on the right hand side. I have to bring 4 here. I cannot bring 4 here. Here if I write 4, it will change the compound totally from water to something else. I do not know, this compound does not exist. So I cannot write a 4 here. Then where do I write a 4? Here, 4H2O outside the box, as I have given in the next slide. 4H2O, right? So Fe plus 4H2O, this 4. Where did the 4 come from? Because there was 4 here, I wrote a 4 here, right? Next, now oxygen is balanced. Now oxygen is balanced, but hydrogen becomes unbalanced. Look here, 4 2s are 8. H2. So on LHS you have 8, RHS you have 2. Start balancing hydrogen. Because here it is 8, I need to write a 4 here. 4 2s are 8, 4 2s are 8. Oxygen is balanced, hydrogen is balanced. Now what remains is Fe. Because you have 3 Fe here, I wrote 3 here. Can I write 3 here? No, I cannot write a 3 here because Fe3 does not exist. So I write a 3 here. 3 Fe plus 4 H2O gives Fe3O4 plus 4 H2O. This is how I balance a chemical reaction. Next, what is to be written? States of substances are to be written. Solid, gas as subscript means little below the normal writing. Next, temperature, pressure and catalyst are to be written above the arrow. Next, what do I do? I have balanced the chemical reaction. I write the physical states. Solid, gas. Next, some chemical reactions require temperature, pressure, catalyst to be written above the arrow. Always remember, temperature, pressure and catalyst are to be written above the arrow. If I don't write this, what will happen? Wrong reaction. It will not proceed because this reaction proceeds only at given pressure, temperature and catalyst. Next, can you balance equation and write solid, gas and liquid? Magnesium is a solid, oxygen is a gas, MgO is a solid. So today we will stop here. If you have any questions regarding any videos, you can feel free to call on 8805-137-642. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel, Dakesh Classes. Thank you.